A again. A sharp. F sharp.
F sharp, okay.
You know, there is a lot of fear about technology, especially in the education sector. When we say that we are using technology while educating young children, there are a lot of eyebrows raised saying that, is it good? I mean, how much technology can you use for young children who really are in a very tender age, and isn't it detrimental? The question really is that technology is detrimental if not appropriately, in the sense that you need to really look at how you are using technology with the children. If the technology makes children a mere consumer, then the technology definitely is detrimental to their growth, their mental development, so and so forth. But if technology is used in an appropriate manner, where technology induces, technology inspires children to understand things that probably they would not have understood just by reading a book or just hearing someone, I really don't see we need to fear the technology. We can do that every course must have course books or the course material plus reference books. So I'm not denying that we should not expose children to the other books. No, not at all. I'm saying put as a additional reading or...
So what we can do, my point was that if you are incorporating competency framework into beginning English and all, then same framework can be put into VLearn because it's far simpler.
Yeah, so what has happened in the last 20 years is that education has become commodified. With the opening up of the Indian market, knowledge has become a commodity to be transacted. Not just knowledge, but the ownership and the process of creating the knowledge is also being owned. And education has become a commodity where the student is a consumer, and it's become a transactional kind of a relationship. Now, this leads to a lot of exclusion where a lot of children or learners or people all across cannot afford or cannot access this sort of exclusive commodified education. In this scenario, we believe that the open education movement, which is a global movement, offers us some solutions. The open education movement basically says that every learner in any part of the world has a right to high quality learning resources. The open education movement also says that I don't only have a right to access, but I have a right to own the knowledge and create it. Now, this is a very big departure from just consuming content or consuming knowledge. So the open education movement says that we should collaboratively remix, retail and build knowledge so that everyone has equal access to it.
Okay, my name is Samprati Gada. I was born and brought up in Mumbai, lived there for about 35 years. But somewhere along the way, I had always felt that the quality of life in a large metropolitan city is not really good. And I was always looking out to moving into a small town or a village. And the opportunity to work with students at Tamarind Tree School came up and I just took it up. And I'm now settled in Dahanu.
मेरा नाम रूपाली है और मैं नैनीताल उत्तराखंड से हूँ तो मैं कुछ नया एक्सप्लोर करना चाहती थी अपनी लाइफ में मैंने इससे पहले जॉब किया था आई वाज इन दिल्ली एंड आई वाज वर्किंग फॉर गुड वन ईयर ओवर देयर बट देन मुझे रियलाइज़ हुआ कि कुछ और एक्सप्लोर करना चाहिए तो मैंने एक फेलोशिप प्रोग्राम ज्वाइन किया इंडिया फेलो और उसके थ्रू मेरे को टैमरिंड ट्री के बारे में पता चला और मेरा यहाँ पे प्लेसमेंट हुआ और मैं एजुकेशन सेक्टर से नहीं हूँ मेरे को इतना ज़्यादा पता नहीं था एजुकेशन सेक्टर के बारे में तो यहाँ के मुझे बहुत सारी नई चीज़ें पता चल रही है डेवलपमेंट सेक्टर के बारे में एजुकेशन सेक्टर के बारे में सो इट इज़ अ वेरी गुड एक्सपीरियंस फॉर मी
नमस्ते मेरा नाम आयुषी है मैं 27 साल की हूँ और किसी भी और मिलेनियल की तरह भटकी हुई हूँ खोई हुई हूँ खुद की तलाश में खुद को बेहतर समझने के लिए यहाँ हूँ मुझे पता चला कि दहानु में ये एक्सपेरिमेंट हो रहा है जहाँ पे कि हम एजुकेशन को एक नए नज़रिए से देखने की कोशिश कर रहे हैं नया नया और ये आइडिया जो है वो हर रोज़ रिफ़ाइन होता है हम हर रोज़ लैब के अंदर बैठ के डिस्कशंस करते हैं और कोशिश करते हैं कि कैसे बेहतर से बेहतर अपना काम कर सकें तो ये जो कांस्टेंट इम्प्रूवमेंट कांस्टेंट थिंकिंग है वो उसने मुझे काफ़ी अट्रैक्ट किया
There is a lot of ambiguous approach to technology. A lot of institutions or educational spaces believe that they have no choice, that there is something happening in the world led by governments or led by corporations, and if we don't introduce technology, then we'll be left behind. And they do it in a sort of a fait accompli kind of a position. And then there are those who oppose it, but somehow by default, they also at some level feel that we must adopt technologies. Now, our position about this is slightly different. We believe that technologies are not being, you know, sort of delivered to us from the sky. We believe it's the community that uses the technology and it's the community that can influence the way these technologies are shaped for our users. Now, this is a very different approach to technology rather than just saying that I'm a beneficiary or I have no choice and I have to use it. That's a disempowering approach. We want an empowering approach where we say we will design or we will shape or by using the technology, by adapting it or adopting it in our spaces, we will change the way the technology is. So in our hope of the way we use it, we hope that the most marginalized communities or we will shape the technology so that the people who have been denied the access to these technologies will be able to use it.
Most people see technology as an external factor. It's not really part of their work. It is not part of their being. It is not part of their political thinking. That externality of technology makes things difficult. Large institutions always think that if they need to deploy technology, they need to have a dedicated technology staff, they need to have IT department, so on and so forth. If technology is woven into your own work, I don't think this fear will remain a fear. It will become a part of your being. today in the time when the information is easily available, it's only that fear which is stopping us from, you know, learning technology ourselves. If we in our minds stop thinking that, you know, technology is something that the experts do and I do something else, if that dichotomy, if that difference is eliminated from our minds, I feel that it's not difficult for anybody. It's just not difficult for anybody to adopt technology. For example, at Tamarind Tree, we seriously do not have any IT department. From managing server-side applications to creating our own animations, we do everything ourselves. Not only me alone or a couple of us, but just about everybody. We encourage them to really use technology in their day-to-day life. And that is showing up, that's showing the results.
People ask us that, how can I shape the technology? Technology is being dumped on me. I'm too small. I'm too insignificant. But the Open Education Resources Movement says that you could be anywhere, any learner, any educator in the world. You could build your own content. You could release it. You could make a video. You could write a text. You could make a painting. Release all of this in the open Creative Commons domain, and others can adapt it, retell it, remix it, contextualize it for their environment. Now, once I do that, I have already reshaped a particular resource that has been released. This is happening in music, this is happening in filmmaking, this is happening everywhere. Why can't it happen in education? Why can't educators build their own content, share it with each other, adapt it and remix it?